Ready ties in the culture, hit you with them can ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was clutter, so subtle, falling out through the rubble. Remember this in jungle, the top, I was gonna get something. The middle, gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing? 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 Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. Look at the institution, modern day execution. Think I know the solution, maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music, just put it in the music.
Someone put me out, cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave. You're burning out if you jump into the fire. Can you feel it rushing through your body? Though you may get all that you desire. No ceiling when that never needs to say. You're burning out if you jump into the fire. What can you feel it rushing through your, right through your veins? Though you may get all that you desire.
Yeah. was head to toe designer. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me, cause I'm rich at poppin' in. Yeah. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit.
First opened way back in 1924, but renovated in 2002. There's a look inside Venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Chicago Bears. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. First carry now for Kareem Hunt. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play. It's second down.
The tackle by.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love the blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
On second and 9, Wilson. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line.
Tyler Boyd.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
Yeah, that was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
At the 34-yard line.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. From the shotgun, Wilson. Throw left side complete. That's Boyd. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
37-yard line.
Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And he'll get three down at the 34-yard line.
Kareem Hunt, the ball carrier.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Second and 7, operating from the 34. They run with Hunt. And a nice run. They're going to take this close to the first down marker at the Bucs 28. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
That one is caught by Hunt, and he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
That's good.
It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook. Pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off of the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
It's on the pickup.
I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4-for-4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing.
And he's going to be dropped back at the 15-yard line.
Vita Vea busting through to get him for a loss of 6.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up 4 last week, didn't they?
Yes. And just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if they're going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, the quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
He'll get this one underneath to Hunt, and he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
So first and goal now from the 7-yard line. They'll run. This is Hunt, and he's going to get forward for about 5, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee? So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Terrible spot for a holding call as he'll try again, but now from further back on first and goal. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago.
And that's something you have to get ready for defensively, because in today's NFL, teams will use their wide receivers on jet sweeps, end arounds. They'll move them back in the backfield and make them running backs. Partner, this was much more of a tap pass, but effective nonetheless.
And I think both guys love it. If you're a quarterback, it's an easy completion. If you're a wide receiver, you get the easy reception and also a chance to try to make a play. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. Kareem Hunt, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bears take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. And he's got it to make it 7-0 in favor of the Bears.
Makes the score Bears 7, Buccaneers nothing.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. Oh, nice move. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
That's the end of the first.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
A very quick pass to Ridley. Calvin Ridley, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And sometimes those slants, they can be so tough to defend after the catch. It just happens so quickly.
And really, what gets set up there is how quickly everything happens. Ball's out of the hands of the passer in a hurry, and he just takes it and goes.
And he went all the way into the end zone. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Slant pass to Boyd. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Brings up second and
nothing
two.
Fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football, complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
The Bears on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This time they face a 3rd and 2.
And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Josh Bynes in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game. But this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football. Because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance, if they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
Yeah, he just danced away from that one defender on his way to a gain of about 7 yards.
Tackle made.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Love this time is going to set up to throw it. And that's going to be incomplete.
That's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. He's able to knock that one away.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll bring up fourth down. On fourth down, punt coming from Braden Mann. He only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. It takes a touchdown-saving tackle to bring him down as he goes 32 yards on the return. And it'll be a short field for the Bears as they take over 1st and 10. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Wilson. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed.
By the Buccaneers.
Oh, man, Brandon, not a real good throw that time. It looked like he tried to put a little too much air under this one, and it turned into a floater. And defensively, this is a dream. He could have fair caught that one. That was way too easy.
They start the drive with Cook. Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
Number 33, Dalvin.
With the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
On the carry.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Following the good run by Cook, here's another 1st and 10. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Jordan Love, ready on first down here. And he'll bring this
this one back to the 29. They brought the house that time on the young rookie, maybe a little rattled through the pick.
And you have to be prepared for a lot of pressure as a rookie quarterback because most defensive coordinators are going to test you that way. So when you see that, the ball's got to get out of your hands quickly, and that means your receivers have to understand they have to break off their routes quickly as well.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
That is caught at the 7. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
First and goal at the 8-yard line.
Now Wilson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former Bear, Adrian Amos. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
They'll take over.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Now the question, what do you do here? Time not really an issue. You got over a minute, but you figure from this spot you need a good 50, 60 yards to even consider a field goal try.
Yeah, so there's optimism there, but there's also a little bit of restraint, right? You got to make sure you don't take a sack here. Don't end up in the end zone. Ball gets stripped. You could give up 2 points in that occasion. Or maybe even 6 if you can't get on it and recover it yourself. So make sure you protect the guy throwing the football if indeed that's the plan of attack.
And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 20. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. First and 10, Love. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Oh, he faked it with a juke. Now he's got some room. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating? The guys who just gave up that play.
Out of the shotgun, it's Love. And that one will fall incomplete.
Intended
block here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half. Good coverage there by Trayvon Mullen. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Love. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And that one almost intercepted. Call it a 50-50 ball. It falls incomplete and now third down.
He was defended.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To Love. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. This is brought in at the 21. So possession goes over here on the punt. And control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Time here for likely one play, and then these two teams will head to the locker room all even.
And you know the play caller's just feeling it right now. Let's go ahead and go for this one. A big shot down. No. Guaranteed the head coach is like, don't get crazy. Take the knee. Let's get out of here. Tie game. We'll just start all over.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Final play of the half, it's Wilson. He'll let this go for the end zone. And that is caught, but the back judge right there to say incomplete. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up.
At the 24-yard line.
Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now. Hotly contested in the third quarter.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Well, CD, a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field. But, man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield. But also, when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
A 3-yard pickup brings up second and 7 at the 46-yard line.
The last run got 3. Now here's second and 7. Switching things up, they'll throw it now with Jordan Love. And this one is incomplete. Rookie Jalen Reagor, the intended target that time. And it's third down. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
And that is incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
They'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And this will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad.
At their own 15-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do in the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie. On second and 9, Wilson. And this one incomplete. Wilson. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. It got his man complete. A big one there on third down. They hit for 30 yards.
And that one hurts defensively. They force him into third and long, had the advantage, yet they give up the big play right there.
Yeah, their offense was already warming up on the sideline, ready to come out. So much for that 3-and-out. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. Here's Hunt.
he'll take this one down to the 36.
The ball carrier.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
6 yard line.
Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
On third and 1, Wilson. He'll let this thing go for Sanders. And that is caught. Touchdown. Emmanuel Sanders, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Bears have taken the lead. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. To pass, here's Jordan Love. Finding room at the 30. And Josh Hill has it. And finally brought down at the 34-yard line. It's a big play, yet amazingly, because of how far they had to go, they're still looking at a second down here. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here's second and a yard from the 34. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
A gain of that's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48.
1 yard gain. Brings up second and 9.
Love now on second down. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. Back now at Soldier Field. It's Buccaneer football, but they've got work to do. They find themselves behind here to start the fourth quarter. The Bucs on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is 3rd and 9. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Give him 9 on the pickup, but they're still a few inches short now on fourth down.
But it brings up fourth.
The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
Here comes the Buccaneers punter now, as he's on to punt for the fourth time tonight. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies. And that flat drop, just kind of kicking the nose of the football, they're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
In on the stop, it's Tahir Whitehead. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back, those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
and 10 yards to go.
The Bears on third down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 10. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. He's got his man, Boyd. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. That'll put him right at 99 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
A 7-yard.
Well, at this stage, that's exactly what you want offensively. Good run on first down, stay in bounds, keep that clock rolling.
And look at that play chart that the play caller has in his hands right now. That's what you got to focus in on, because that's divided up by sections. And right now, he's looking at that 4-minute offense section. What running plays do we have to bleed down the clock and take care of the football? Right now, they're executing really well.
And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
1st and 10 at the 45-yard line.
They'll run on first down. Hunt. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at 3rd and 1.
Brings up 3rd and 1.
Here we go. 3rd and 1. Gut check time on both sides. 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to 4th down.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on 3rd down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected 4th down here.
And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line. And for an offense that is struggling, this is not where you want to start from. Great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters do during the course of practice each and every day? The best ones do what we just saw there. Work on positioning the football and helping their team.
A quick throw out to Hardman on the perimeter. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. That catch good for only a couple.
And 8 at the 11-yard line.
Here's Love. That'll be caught. Rager with it. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. That one a gain of 20 and a first down.
1st down, Tampa Bay.
They'll throw this out wide and complete it to Ridley. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. His 2nd catch, this one not quite as dynamic as his first. And it's 2nd down.
2nd and 4.
Second down at 4. From the gun, it's again to Cole. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. No. The coverage unit out there thinking pass on third and three. Love. And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. And yes, he's into the end zone. So they get the late score they needed. And now the extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down one. That extra point is not a gimme.
And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth.
Brandon McManus set to kick off.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Wilson to throw. That's into the hands of Pascal. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts, as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number two. So the big play has them all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Now Wilson. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver. But a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. This is Hunt on the draw play. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. So on comes the kicker, Dustin Hopkins, in a big spot. This to almost certainly win the football game. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. But hang on, a flag is down. Now, if it's on the defense, they might decline it and take the points. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this carries into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Now Love. This ball complete to Rager. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
First down.
From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10. They'll look to throw. That's to Dalvin Cook, his running back. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. Now McManus will line up for the field goal. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. Now McManus will line up for the field goal. With 3 seconds to go, if it's good, we're off to overtime. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he returns this to the 22.
And Grant on the return. The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
And it's been loud in here so far. Play fake. Here's Love. And it's caught. The tight end Hill. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
It's a gain of 23 yards,
the final tally. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Love now. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. And he goes out right around the 39. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
39-yard line.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. Now a run with Cook. And able to get a couple as he's across the 40 to the 41.
Dalvin Cook, the ball carrier, taken down at the 41. It's a gain of 2 yards. And it's third down.
And they need 5 yards on third down here to keep this opening drive of OT alive. To throw now. Here's Love. He's got his man. That's Hardman. Pass the 20.
Bring in the second string.
And he is in for the score. And it is absolute stunned silence here as they win it on the road in overtime.
Final score.
Partner, a great game that we got to see, and making it extra special. Not only did I get four quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really just wanted four quarters, what you wanted. But how much fun was that? We had that type of a game where we got us to overtime, and then we get the dramatic ending to finish things off as well. What a game.
So for Tampa Bay, they move back over 500 at 3-2 now on the year. And they'll get a few extra days to savor this one before they take on the Green Bay Packers. Meanwhile, for Chicago, they drop below 500 to 2-3 with a loss. And they'll be on the road next week for a matchup with the Carolina Panthers. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
We'll be right back. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Now we on top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pay for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's still private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins in the wheels suspended. I told them what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah, hey. I had to tighten the plan. Got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just hit my dance. I was pop. They just watched. Had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go to the can and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest of brand, but he folding again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10.
Head to toe designer. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much strength on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah, drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha-cha macha with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, duckin' 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me feel myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
They don't know my name. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You were raised so to